Sometimes the hindrance we have is not because of the economy, it's not because of the devil, it's not because of God, but one or two sins we are hiding. You know the sins you are hiding. Nobody must know it's a secret. Don't tell anybody. It's my secret. You will begin to, even though you come to church, but you still have sin you are hiding. Sin is with you, and sin is the empowerment of evil. You will not be happy. You will be in the church. You don't know what is the joy of the Lord. We're talking about the joy of the Lord. You don't know it. We're talking of God. You won't even know God, for the pure in heart is the only one that has access to see God. You will be hearing, you can mention and claim all the promises of the Bible. None of them will work for you. It's because you have locked the door. And inside of that door is you and sin. And light and darkness can stay together. You will be hearing everything, but no change. You don't know what is repentance. You know what it says? It says, except you are born again, you can't see. So, when you are not able to see, you will not be behaving well because you are a blind person. Amen? You are not able, you can't see. When we say, let's worship God, you can't see it. It doesn't get to you. Why should I worship Him? We come, we are listening to, they are writing, you are hearing the word of God, you can see it. Even though your eyes open, you can't, you don't get to know, you are locked out, you are out of the game. He said you can't see the kingdom of God except you are born again. So that born again is what the Bible calls repentance. And what is that repentance? Isaiah 55 verse 7, he says, let the wicked abandon his ways. Okay, abandon your ways. You are only hiding it to pastor. You are only hiding it to some people. Why are you talking to me about publicly? You are only hiding the public. It's not really public. The devil knows about it. One or two persons knows about it. Evil spirits all over, billions of them, they have number. They know about what you're hiding. So anyone who hides is sin. Whatever sin, you know it. Proverbs 28:37 will not succeed. That is why you will see some people, even with millions of dollars, they commit suicide. One of the richest men in Germany, around 2011 or 2012, with all his billions, life meant nothing to him. Must be around that time, because I read in the newspaper. What he did, parked his car, came in front of, target the train coming. Just stay inside and throw himself, the train pieces. But the story continues everywhere. You see very rich people you think successful, money and all the things of the world cannot. It's not a replacement. Church is not a replacement for repentance. Except you are born again, you cannot see the kingdom of God. Matthew 5, it says, the pure in heart shall see God. It's not the rich in money. Amen? It's not the beautiful in face or handsome in face. The pure in heart. That purity of heart is the heart. It's not that you are perfect, but that you have surrendered your life to Him. Repentance is God's command to the sinner. He said, let the wicked abandon his ways, and the righteous man his thoughts. And what will you receive? If you, how many minutes more do I have?
1 minute.
No, can be. Okay, don't worry. I won't be preaching long in the during the message. Amen. So you will cover, we will still finish with time. Let your righteous man his thoughts. When you throw away your sin, when you come to God and say, oh, don't deny, that is it. God, I don't want to sin anymore. Remember, Jesus did not come down from heaven and became human being by your power. It's by the grace of God. We are saved by the grace of God, favor. So, it's not by your power you will stop sinning. You need the blood of sacrifice upon your life. Sin comes to take your life. When the blood of Jesus is in you, when it comes Jesus, they will see the sacrifice you have paid. Somebody has paid for your life. Amen. You have the freedom to live. So with that song, we will sing it. I am free to run. I am free to dance. I am free to live again. I am free. You can only experience that freedom. The Bible says in Psalm 32, it says, blessed is the man whose sins are forgiven, whose transgression God has moved away, who does not carry guilt conscience. Amen. No more guilty conscience. You are free. You are free. You have freedom. The Bible says in Corinthians, for it was for freedom that Christ has set us free. No longer again to be entangled in the works of the devil. It was for freedom. That is the missing messages in the world, in the church today. We come to church for many years, we're still as we are. They tell you, it's okay. In the end, it's disappointment. You know, every day in your life, you're not experiencing God. If there is God at all, you're not experiencing. You know you are far away from Him. You know you don't know Him. You know you are still sinful. And they encourage you, no one is perfect. No, it's not about no one being perfect. It's about you receiving forgiveness for your sins. For somebody has died for you. It's you knowing that there is a way out. You can stop sinning. Not by your own power. All you need is your obedience and cooperation with God. Sin is a complete, repentance is a complete and conscious turning away from all sins. You look at sin. Yeah. I've been in this. God, your word says I'm guilty. I believe I'm guilty. Forgive me for all my sins. And because it's you, turn your back to sin and look up and say, God, give me the grace. Forgive me and give me the power to live above those sins. Only the power of God, the grace, that's what is here, the grace of God. Only that one can help you live above sin. Only that one can cleanse your conscience and make your conscience free from guilt. Somebody said, yes, in my house, no, I will make no girlfriends. All women, I will stop them coming. Pastor, but only one. Because I told him you need to repent of all sin. Say, but only one girlfriend will be coming. Other ones will not be coming. Only one. I said, that means you still have not repented. One equals to 1,000. Amen. Maybe one sin. You say, I will stop all the sins, but only one. And that one, you hide it somewhere. You don't let everybody know you can do that thing. He that hides his sin will not succeed. So even though you are not doing 99, you are still doing one. But that one equals to 99. Anyone who is hiding sin, you may be a pastor, you may be a teacher, you may be an elder, you may be a worker, you may be a church member. If there is sin in your life, you are hiding. It is not the law of government. It is the law of God. The sun, the moon, the earth you are standing, they are working against you. There is only safety. The only savior is Jesus Christ. Only Jesus can save. True salvation, true savior is only to money don't save. Good wife or good husband don't save. Good children can save. Good ideas can save. Living in good houses, beautiful houses can save. Only Jesus can save. That is where the price for sin, in him the price for sin was paid. And it was paid for you. So abandon ways. Repentance, turning away from sin completely, and all its deceitful pleasures. And also turn away from Satan and turn unto God through Jesus Christ. That is repentance. That is what God calls born again. That's what the Bible calls regeneration. Now we see, how do you now see? You've seen the life in the past. You know how you live without God. How is it now you're a church member? How is it now you're a church worker? How is your life now? Do you still love sin? Do you still practice sin? 1 John chapter 3 says that anyone who is practicing sin does not know God. You lie today, you lie tomorrow, you lie, you continue just like that. You don't hate sin. He said you have not seen God or know God. 2 Corinthians 5:17, if anyone be in Christ, if anyone knows Christ, if anyone is in Christ Jesus, say, all things have passed away. What are the old things? Compare your life. Don't let another person be judging you. Compare your life. Are all things passed away? Before you were born again, every week or two, three days, you mark up, mark down, and put in the Facebook. Now you still go to church. Now you carry Bible. And you are still, wait, I won't do it on Monday morning. I will do it on Sunday night. Now you finish church, you go out again. The same thing, you change clothes. The same life. So I'm going to church first, I won't sing. It's when I finish on my way back after church. Today, in fact, you postpone the decision to Monday because say today is Sunday. I won't sing today, Sunday. I will sing on Monday. Check your life. Are all things passed away? It will be a deception. You know the devil goes to church too, not only you. If all these things you know, all these things are offered to you free, salvation is offered to you free of charge, all you need to, God, I am a sinner, forgive me. Huh. The instrument you are playing, praise and worship members, he won't save anyone. Those of us who are preaching and teaching well, will not save anyone. It's by your obedience. By your obedience that you can see God. And what a difference if you can see God. Seeing God every day means God always active in your life every day. He said, oh God, even though I'm a sinner, I'm still alive, like Pastor Joe, like Pastor Daniel. We are all alive. Are you okay? You want to die now? Each day is opportunity given to you to change, to repent. Each day. He said, do we count the grace of God in vain? Every day is grace given to you. Somebody has been praying for you to repent. So each day you say, hey, I'm alive. All those, we're all alive. So what's the difference? The difference is, except you are born again, you can see. You can see God. Workers, thank God for your desire to serve God. But serving God first begins with giving God yourself. Bible says in Ephesians 2, 8, 9, 10, say, for by grace we have been saved. Not of works, not by your playing instrument, not by your being usher, not by your doing evangelism, not by, you are saved without works. Everyone is by grace we are saved. But now that you are saved, what now are your works? Before you were not saved, you have the works of sin. Now that you are saved, Matthew chapter 3 verse 7, he says, produce evidence that you are saved. Let's see your character when somebody scratch you, what you do. Ah! Huh? No, so it's you. I will see you downstairs. We will settle. God, on a good day, we will see you in church. You will see, you will know me. Don't be confused with the Bible I'm carrying when you are seeing it. Don't be confused. We will see. And then Filipino, you say, no problem. You are insulting me. We will drink coke together. We will drink. Listen. Produce evidence. Now, how can you be tempted? How can you prove that you are not in Christ? You have been forgiven. How can you prove your obedience? When the devil sins against you, you don't need, the devil doesn't need your forgiveness. Amen? It's your call. But it's when your sister in the church sins against you. The devil say, that one is my own. God say, the angel say, that one is a child of God. And then Bible says in Hebrews chapter 12, it says, we are surrendered by so many witnesses. When the sister sins against the sister, let's see what they will do. Are you born again? No, I don't want, I can forgive, but I cannot forgive. I can forgive, but we can't sit on the same seat anymore. He said, the way God forgives you, the same way you forgive. When God forgave you, you still breathe. Amen? Yeah. So that is how you test. God allows us to be tested. It is not that people in the church, I'm preaching on that next week, by God's grace, next Sunday. It's not that people in the church, so it's just arranged. Sometimes, show that you are born again. Can you forgive? And each one you fail, you must repeat. Amen? Amen. You show the fruits of your works. Show the fruit of your repentance. When you are now instructed, do you say, yes, sir, yes, ma'am, or no? Don't you remember me, good? And God, don't take instruction. Who are you to instruct me? Don't talk to me anymore. And then you finish praising that. Let's praise the Lord, hallelujah! And then talk to that. And then you come back again. It's called bipolar. Madness. Double identity. That's what psychology is called. Bipolar. Praising the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Lord is good. Hallelujah. And the scripture. Pastor, the Lord is good. Amen. Hallelujah. Share the Lord. Hallelujah. And somebody, if I'm not born again, I will break your head. If I'm not, if not that I'm filled with the Holy Ghost, I would have. I'm warning you. Take it out. If not that this. Holy Ghost, I'm filled with the Holy Ghost. I know what I will do with you. Amen. Praise the Lord. Madness. But remember, when these things come up, now it's today, as you surrender your life to Christ and turn away from sin, you will be tested. You will be tested to backslide. You will be given job and Bible study together. Amen. The same time. They will wait. I know when time Bible study is. Once they know the time Bible study, okay, God, can we test your daughter? Can we test that your son? Employer will come before it's freedom for you that time. Oh, we have work this time. The pastor pay me. The call is your call, not my call. It's your exam, not my exam. Then you look, you choose the work, you leave the Bible. The Bible is God, God's word, and God's word is God. It won't take time, for sin is the strength of the law. Problems will begin to manifest. You say, it's like God is not answering my prayer. God is not hearing our prayer. Pastor, pray for me. This one, pray. You now become prayer collector. Prayer, prayer, prayer. No, it's because you failed the exam. Or you refuse to forgive. The way you forgive, as I said last Sunday, you left. Or you quit. That is the way you forgive. Or you'll be in the same church, but that one, I won't talk to that one. Never! Because I've forgiven him because of Christ. Hallelujah. That is your exam, brothers and sisters. That is your exam. I know what it is. I preach regularly by God's grace, at least for these past decades. And there are people that said that one, I will never forgive. And then on Sunday, I will still preach. God said, forgive as God has forgiven you. So also forgive. Hallelujah. 5 minutes more. That is big for me. Amen.
Amen.
We're talking about repentance. That is the only way to see God. And when you don't see God, you will end up in hell. While on earth yet, even if 1 billion is given to you, you will still be in hell on earth. Adam's problem started while on the Garden of Eden. You remember?
Yes.
Fear, shame, losses. Even in the garden, you don't think church is a covering. It's not for sin. Only the blood of Jesus is a covering for sin. Friendship is not a covering for sin. Religion is not a covering. Only the blood. Blessed is he whose sins are forgiven. Are your sins forgiven? Dancing cannot cover your sin. Nothing can cover. Only the blood. And blood is life. The life of your mother or your father or your children cannot cover. It's still dirty like your own. Only the blood of Jesus is pure to cover sins. Only him is the acceptable sacrifice for you to gain back your life. As God has created you, the life you live outside of Christ is a life that is, it's supposed to call it a loser's game. You are still a loser. And in time and in eternity, you will continue in problems. Anyone who covers a sin will not succeed. That is the judgment of God. That is the word of God. But he says the grace of God is what saves us. How would you know you are? You will have signs, as I'm saying, if you are really born again, remember, don't cover. You will begin to hate sin. Job chapter 1, verse 1 says, for Job, a man without blame, who eschewed evil. Anything sinful, you don't like it. Don't deceive yourself. Anything bad inside of you, you won't like it. And that will be the reason why you don't commit sin. Because inside, that's not okay. Why would you talk? Sometimes people do something, you ask, how can you do something like this? Why did you? You can imagine it. Why? The reason the etrua is missing. Why? What is the rationale for this? Why you get to do this? Genuine repentance brings hatred for sin. The joy of salvation comes when you have peace with God. Even though with nothing, no money, even with no food, even in the midst of problems, those are, remember, they are trials. They are trials. The fire for 3 Hebrews was a trial. Nebuchadnezzar's food and drink for Daniel and his friend was a trial. 3 years trial. For over 90 years of power and influence for Daniel. Joseph tried for 13 years, to last for a lifelong and generational blessings was a trial for 13 years. Was a trial. Whatever problems you have, as long as you are in Christ, it's a trial that will pass away. It doesn't last. One preacher puts it this way: tough times don't last, tough people do. But when you are in sin, they last and stay. Not only in time, but in eternity. There is hatred for sin. There is change of life. Bible study will be interesting. Prayer will be interesting. Your life purpose is changed. And that is what it means to be born again. You've heard all this. The choice is yours. You can choose to continue to be a new church member, but not born again. It's your choice. All that covering cannot protect you. If you are here, you are hearing my voice inside of your heart, you still love sin, then because you love sin, you will continue to act it out. It's your choice, because you have a choice. The blood of Jesus. Except one is born again, he cannot see. Come unto me, all you who labor and are heavy laden. I will give you rest. Matthew 11:28-29. I will give you rest. Let's rise up as we pray. It's up to you. Talk to God by yourself. I've spoken for basically an hour now to you. Up to you. Talk to God by yourself. And your sins covered. You can come to God. God, I have sinned. I'm a sinner. Forgive me my sins. I'm sorry for all I have done against you. I cannot stop by my own power. God, give me your power. Stop moving around. Close that door. Amen. Close. Pray. I say, call for prayer. There is no, the devil is the one afraid of prayer. You didn't move before. Now I say prayer. You're moving around. Everybody say, pray. Ushers, close the door. Nobody coming in. Those who go out, let them stay there. Those inside, pray. Open your mouth and talk to God. You'll be hearing for 1 hour. Now talk to God. He will have mercy. He will give forgiveness to you. Only those who truly repent receive forgiveness. You don't have to continue in damnation. God wants you restored to the original purpose for which you are created. Are you in Christ Jesus? If you are in Christ Jesus, are all things new now in your life? Are you experiencing new joy? Are you experiencing peace? Do you have peace with God? Do you have hope in God? Do you have hope of eternal life? What have you got with you? For you, in this, what is in it for you? Talk to God. Forgive me. Cleanse me of my sins. I'm sorry, God. I want forgiveness. I want forgiveness. Open your mouth and pray. Stop looking at the TV. Open your mouth and pray. Speak out. For with the heart, man believes. With the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. The past and the present. Is your repentance genuine or fake one? Is it fake or genuine? That is what you ask yourself. Stop deceiving yourself. No one, the devil cannot deceive you except you first of all deceive yourself. Is your repentance genuine or fake? Talk to God to cleanse you. Lord, I give my life to you. I give my heart to you. I turn away from all sins. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, thank you for your word. Your children have heard. And God, I pray. For as many as have responded to you for forgiveness, forgive them, O God, according to your promise. Cleanse, let there be cleansing of the heart. And let there be restoration to original plan. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. God bless you.